Hello and welcome to I'll Review It, where things are reviewed. Well, the wait is over. You people wanted a review of chess, so let's give you a review of chess. Before we begin, I'd first like to go over a few things. While I know there is a huge fan base for this game, I have to admit I don't own a chess board. While I asked my fans to donate me one, it hasn't arrived yet, and I'm on a strict schedule. If I miss the deadline by so much as one day, I won't make enough ad revenue to pay my bills. So I'll be reading the rulebook to chess instead. I'm sure it'll have the same effect. So with that out of the way, let's dig into Hoyle's Rules of Games and see how exactly you play chess.
His name is Dalton, and he reviews things like Nignog and Batman and other things. He reviewed Dix once, and it's fucking stupid. I don't even want a theme song.
The cover is just awful. The chess queen is just standing around, showing off her huge bust and slim waistline. The king is munching on piles upon piles of chips, and the ace is standing over the queen's dead body. Wow, we haven't even opened the book yet, and already we've got some woman dying just to further the plot of a man we don't know. Real flippin' classy, Hoyle. We open to page 213, where the rules of chess are being discussed. The origin of chess has been the subject of innumerable legend and fanciful histories. The earliest description of a game, unmistakably chess, comes from the 8th century. Not from an Egyptian papyrus of 4000 BC, as was once asserted. There is little doubt, however, that chess developed from simpler board games of remote time. Chess is played by two, on a board with pieces of special design. Chess is played by two, on a board with pieces of special design. The pieces are made in two colors, the darker being used by player black, and the lighter by player white. The board is a large square of 8x8 smaller squares, which are colored alternatively dark and light. The board is placed so that each player finds a light square in the corner at his right. In printed diagrams, the bottom edge by custom represents the white edge, the top edge, the black. See first diagram. The pieces. Each player has 16 pieces of his own color. To begin the game, there are... Each player has 16 pieces of his own color. To begin a game, they are placed on the board as shown in the diagram. The pieces on each side are 8 pawns, 2 rooks, 2 knights, 2 bishops, 1 queen, and 1 king. Powers of the pieces. There are 6 different kinds of pieces, and each kind has their own powers peculiar to itself. The king is invariably the tallest piece of the set. Its crown is usually the shape suggested by the printed symbol. The king moves one square at a time in any direction on the rank, sideward, on the file, forward or backward, or on the diagonal. Of course, it may not move to a square attacked by an adverse piece. The two kings can never stand on adjacent squares. The queen is the second tallest piece. It wears a crown with points. It is the most powerful piece, being able to move in any directions, on a line of adjacent squares, and any distance so long as no obstructions intervene. Another way of saying it is that the queen combines the powers of the rook and bishop. The rook is a cylindrical tower with a castellated top. It may move any distance along an unobstructed rank or file. The bishop is topped by a mitre, usually marked with a cleft. It moves on diagonal lines only, any distance along an unobstructed line. The knight has the head of a horse, and is often colloquially... The knight has the head of a horse, and is often colloquially called a horse. Unlike all other pieces, it does not move on a line, but from point to point. Consequently, it cannot be obstructed by any intervening pieces. Its move has been described from one corner to the corner diagonally opposite of a rectangle, 3 squares by 2. The pawn is invariably the shortest piece on the board. It moves only forward on the file, away from the owner's side of the board. For its first move, it only has a choice of going forward one square or of jumping to the second away. After it has left its initial square, it may go only one square at a time. Capturing. All pieces except the pawn capture in the same way as they move. If an adverse piece stands on a square of that a king, queen, rook, bishop, or knight can move to, the move captures it. The captured piece is removed from the board, and the square it is occupied is taken by its captor. I lost my place. The pawn alone has a different mode of capture. It does not attack a piece standing ahead of it on the file. Consequently, it can be blocked without the power of... The pawn alone has a different mode of capture. It does not attack a piece standing ahead of it on the file. Consequently, it can be blocked without the power of fighting back. The pawn captures diagonally on the square adjacent and forward. Thus, it attacks at most two squares, and if it is at the side of the board, it attacks only one. The pawn has another peculiarity, the capture en passant, or in passing. Suppose a white pawn is advanced from its initial square by a double jump, and a black pawn stands on an adjacent file, from which it would have attacked the white pawn had it been moved one square only. The black pawn may make the capture, moving to the square jumped over by the white pawn. The object in allowing this en passant capture is to preserve the principle that an advancing pawn is bound to meet attack from the adverse pawn standing on both adjacent files. But if the en passant capture is not made at once in response to the double jump, it may not be made at all. The play. White always makes the first move, and thereafter the players move alternatively. Is anyone still listening at this point? It's been like 5 or 6 minutes. I've literally just been like reading the rule book. Like, I guess you might still be watching this like you're expecting a joke or something. I mean, I wouldn't expect a joke. Linkara is a boring guy. He doesn't really have much to work with other than, like, his personality quirks. I mean, he essentially just reads the comic anyway. This is the best I can do. I'm sorry if you're bored. Like, how bored are you if you're watching this series? All right, well, I'm going to skip ahead just so I can... not read this whole thing, which is fucking awful. Drawn games. A game may be drawn under any of the following circumstances. Lack of force. The pieces left on the board are too weak to force checkmate. Perpetual check. One player shows that he can check the adverse king without cessation. Stalemate. A player in turn to move can make no legal move, yet his king is not in check. Repetition. The same position of all pieces, white and black, recurs 3 times in a game, with the same player to move each time. On the third occasion, the player may claim a draw. 50 move rule. Each player may claim a draw if during 50 moves by one player, no pawn has been moved and no capture has been made, unless his opponent can demonstrate a forced win. This is the actual effect of rather a complicated game clause in the laws of chess. I'll skip one more time because this is a lot. Okay. Oh shit, I don't have to. That's the end. And so our rules end with the beginning of the rules to checkers, another awful sexist game. This game sucks. All it offers is death and violence towards women, and I don't like it, and I don't like you for that matter.